But our next match before that second men's singles semi-final is the second of the mixed doubles semi-finals, and it's the only home interest on semi-finals day. It is Marcus Ellis and Lauren Smith, the number four seeds, against the former champions Yuta Watanabe and Arisa Higashino. Well, as far as the mixed doubles draw is concerned, we had five different nationalities and five seeds at quarterfinal stage. And as you can see, two pairs from Japan and one Japanese pair is already through to the final, with a remarkable comeback in the second game from 4-16 down against Goan Chan, and coming through to win it 22-20 that second game. It was one of the most remarkable comebacks I've ever seen. But here is the English combination, Marcus Ellis and Lauren Smith. They've only played once before against their opponents of today, and that was in the second round of last year's All England Championships. And because Ellis and Smith went on to reach the semi-final stage, they must have won that second round encounter. In fact, it was only 38 minutes, 21-15, 21-10. But the Japanese pair have been in two All England finals. They won the title in 2018, beating Chan Chi-wei and Wang Yashiong in the final, and then lost to that same pair in 2019. But it's a fourth semi-final at the All England Championships for this Japanese pair, a second for the English pair. So English pair winning the toss there and choosing to serve. Well, Yuta Watanabe is already booked his place on finals day in the men's doubles with Hiroyuki Endo. They, of course, are the defending champions in the men's doubles. And this man, Yuta Watanabe, the left-hander, 23 years of age, he, by ensuring a final tomorrow, has ensured that it will be a fourth final in 4 years at the All England Championships, two men's doubles and two mixed doubles. He's trying to make it five finals in 4 years. His partner, Arisa Higashino, is 1 year older, the age of 24, and you can see that they have been as high as three, but currently number six on the world ranking. Haven't played a tournament since last year's All England, where, as I was telling you, they lost in the second round. But here this year, they beat Labar Antrin from France in the first round, and then Christiansen and Boyer of Denmark, and then in the quarterfinal against number six seeds, Tan Kien Ming and Lai Pei Jing of Malaysia. Marcus Ellis is 31 years of age, born in Huddersfield, and he and his partner two places down from their career high of seven. Lauren Smith is 29 years of age, born in Carlisle, and it's their fourth consecutive All England Championships as a pair. The best was last year when they reached the semi-final before losing to the eventual champions Jordan and Octavianti. They were semi-finalists last tournament they played, which was a couple of weeks ago at the Swiss Open. And they, like their opponents, have won all of their matches in two straight games. And the first two rounds were against pairs promoted from the reserve list, and then the quarterfinal against Mikkel Mikkelsen and Rikki Sobe. Two close games against the Danes, as we look at our umpire Seamus Halpin of Ireland, and the service judge François Metson from France. So Morton, one previous meeting between these two pairs and the English pair came out on top.
Yes, that's correct, but if my memory serves me right, I think that Higashino was having some injury problems last year at this time, but I'm not entirely sure, but I think there was something about an ankle or but I'm not entirely sure. It's just purely from memory.
Yeah, she badly twisted her ankle, but that was at the Asian Championships of 2019.
Yeah, but I think it was sort of hampering her a bit.
It was a reoccurrence?
For quite a while.
Yeah,
I think.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Arisa Higashino, Yuta Watanabe, Japan. And on my left, Marcus Ellis and Lawrence Smith, England. Lawrence Smith to serve to Arisa Higashino. Love all. Play.
So can Marcus Ellis and Lauren Smith end the 14-year wait for a home pair to reach the final at the All England Championships? And that's across any discipline. The last finalists were indeed in the mixed doubles discipline. Anthony Clark and Donna Kellogg losing the final 14 years ago.
Service over.
And for this English combination, they've never been in a World Tour final above a 300 event. So this would be a major, major breakthrough if they could win this semi-final here at a 1,000, the highest level of HSBC BWF World Tour events. Oh, that's a nice play from Watanabe.
Yeah, good placement.
2-12. Change.
Yeah, when I said earlier about the injury to Higashino, of course, I didn't mean that the English player couldn't win, but I think the scores last time they played was a little bit too convincing.
Yeah, 15 and 10. It was very one-sided. I don't remember. I don't think I called that one a year ago.
I didn't either.
3-0.
Maybe I did. I really can't remember. I can't remember what matches I called yesterday.
Yeah. I know what you mean. Sometimes you do get in doubt.
That's a lucky block, or is that just practice skill?
Yeah, who knows. But he's a very, very skillful player.
Yeah.
Watanabe. And the English pair really have to watch out.
Yeah, need to settle, and they
Five.
Need to settle quickly.
Love.
Oh, great defense from Higashino. Higashino is a very athletic player. And if she gets pushed to the back of the court, don't be surprised to see her doing jump smashes.
Yeah, she's almost jumping as high as her partner. She's very good from the back.
Now, this is not the start the English pair wanted. 7-love lead for the former champions and number 2 seeds, Watanabe and Higashino. Well, of course, both the English players played 2 matches yesterday. They were in 2 quarterfinals, obviously the men's doubles and the women's doubles as well. But in all honesty, it's Yuta Watanabe that's played the most matches, isn't it? Because he's already played 1 semi-final. He also played 2 matches yesterday. Look at that movement from Higashino.
Very, very good interception.
Yeah.
1-8.
Put off the mark for the English pair.
But after the comeback in the previous mixed doubles, we are going to say nothing about what will happen in this opening game. But I still think that it's very, very important for Ellis and Smith to get points on the scoreboards and perhaps not winning this opening game, but get some confidence back. get into the match.
Higashino saw that Smith was following forward, desperate to try and get it over her head, but well wide of the mark. If you're a Japanese fan, you'll be absolutely delighted. If you are an English fan, you'll be rather worried.
Very concerned. 5 minutes only.
And 11-2, the advantage to the number two seeds and former champions. Peter Jeffrey, the English coach, try and get to the front a little bit more. Take control of the front. Well, I know this is far too early to make predictions, Morton, but I did research the last time that there was a same nation mixed doubles final at the All England Championships. And you actually have to go back 17 years, which I was surprised about, to 2004, when it was an all-Korean mixed doubles final. I would have put money on an all-Chinese final since then, but
yes.
No.
12-2.
And we're certainly not there yet, but the way that the Japanese pair is playing at the moment, it looks promising that it could be a same nation final.
Yeah, women's doubles, men's doubles, mixed doubles.
All Japanese finals, all three. Mm. Well, let's hope for a comeback from Ellis and Smith for the home fans. Even though there's none in the stadium here, there'll be many watching on television. Oh, that was a good serve.
Yeah, he's serving really well. It's so hard to attack it, isn't it?
Yeah.
14-2.
That's a good defense.
That's wide.
What is it, do you think, Morton? Do you think that the English pair have come out in a little bit nervous, or just the first few rallies that they lost confidence, or what's the problem? This is not the way we're used to seeing the English pair play.
No, but they have to push up the court. They have to get Lauren Smith much, much closer to the net. She's got to start taking control. And then, of course, it's all about Marcus Ellis also pushing up behind her. So they're closing that mid-court area down, because this is, as you see, much better. The problem is that the defence from the Japanese is really, really good, and they have to work so hard to get their points. But this is a good way.
Yeah.
They have to keep working and working and working. Wait for the chance.
Yeah, well, that was a fabulous rally and the longest so far.
3-15.
But this is actually what it takes to perhaps score points against the two Japanese. Gotta have patience, but on the other hand, they also have to take control and move up the court. They've been standing far too back. And that's an excellent return from Watanabe down the line. Try to have a look at it if we get it again, because that is awesome. Look at this. That's nice. And once again, good serving this time from Higashino.
17.
And that's also part of the secret. The two Japanese are serving very well.
I feel this first game, even though we've seen an extraordinary comeback today in one of the matches, it's gone. I think this opening game is gone. But it is vital, I think, that the English pair play themselves into the match before the start of the second game.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to say earlier when it was like 8-1.
Yeah.
That it's so important for them to get back into it somehow, so they get a little bit of confidence.
Ellis was prepared to go forward there. He was anticipating a drop shot. Didn't actually come over, but watch his movement here. Yes, he's looking for that.
Yeah, he was placing Higashino at the back of the court quite nicely. She wanted to come forward, and that's the way to play that drop shot, so he knew that would come. Good play by Watanabe.
There's the jump smash. Absolutely brilliant from Higashino.
She generates a lot of power from the back. And that cross-court drive, half smash, to finish the rally was really well played as well. Trying to have a look at the serve here. Watanabe serving. And Lauren Smith have to play it from below the tape. But good interception from Lauren Smith on the third shot.
7-18. Almost landed in. Misjudgment there from Watanabe. Great bounce on that shot. 18. Just long.
Service over. 19-8. Service over.
It's a nice return of serve. Just enough pace on it to make it awkward for Higashino.
19.
And placed on her backhand side as well.
Game point 9.
But it's good to see that Marcus Ellis is turning around. Yeah, look at that. He is turning. He knows that this is trouble.
Mm. So game point opportunities for the former champions.
As you would say, a whole host of it.
Yeah. But not this time.
10-20.
Don't you think it's psychologically important to get double figures? Get to 10. I think that's very important. When you have a game that's not going your way at all, it's important to get double figures.
Service error from Marcus Ellis, and that gifts the opening game to Yuta Watanabe and Arisa Higashino. 21-10, opening game in 14 minutes. Well, I don't know if you caught any of that, Morton, but I think that Peter Jeffrey was saying she hasn't taken any off, she hasn't killed off the top of the tape. Don't be afraid.
Yeah. I think he was trying to give them a lot of encouragement and, you know, try in that way to get them back into this match. And the opening of this second game is just utterly important.
Mm.
One love.
Watanabe. He was encroaching forward onto the net and lifted it over his head, and he still got back in time to smash it cross court.
He's a quick man. Quick on his feet.
Look, he's going forward, then suddenly has to change his mind and still hits a winning smash.
That's good placement as well, across the body on the forehand side of Lauren Smith. That would have been a winner.
Yeah.
2-1. It's interesting when the English coach is saying that she hasn't killed anything on top of the tape. But the thing is that Lauren Smith is pushing everything away from the net. Every single shot when she's approaching is pushed into the mid-court area. And she's got to test whether Higashino will be there to kill it or not. But she's not testing it, and I think that's what the coach wants. Let's see whether she's there or not.
That was the most amazing reaction on the defence there from Watanabe. Not only reaction, but where he placed it. That's really extraordinary.
Two. Service over. Three. All.
So that one, you wanted another neck shot rather than
yes.
that little push.
Okay, but it works well. This one, it works well. Yeah. There was no trouble in that. But yes, test at the net a bit more.
Just unbelievable. What a drop shot.
Is all over the place. Completely controlling it. Of course, immensely well supported by Higashino. But that shot is nice. And here we saw another example of how Lauren Smith is pushing it away from the net. Good play by Ellis.
Five.
Return of serve was good. Even Watanabe couldn't get to that one.
Now it's double hit by the English pair.
But I think it's very professional what Watanabe did. Takes no chances, just still play the shot, making sure, you know, in case the umpire should miss it.
Good play from Higashino.
Yeah, the problem for Smith is that she's playing
seven,
it again
five.
Half court area, but also not only that, but on the forehand side of Higashino.
Much faster movement now in this second game by both the English players.
Six, seven.
That's good anticipation from Watanabe.
Oh, behind the back.
Service over. Eight, six.
Yeah, she's very alert on that front court, Higashino. Yeah. Oh, lucky net court from Marcus Ellis. Oh, we all need a little bit of luck at times.
7-8.
Awesome play.
Yeah, fabulous rally. Reaction speed, just incredible. What was that, block? Don't forget the block.
Yeah, but I think that Jeremy, he likes a lot of blocks, and I think he got it. I think that Watanabe was blocking quite a few of those shots.
Yeah. Swing of the racket there from Lauren Smith.
She's not happy.
No.
You can see the body language. She's definitely not happy.
4-point advantage, having already won the first for Watanabe and Higashino.
Twenty seconds.
It's going to be hard, but you've got to fight for it. Brilliant again. What a great drop shot.
Yeah, favourite shot. Loves that disguised block shot from the back. But it was interesting to see that the rally started by the turn of serve from Ellis, where he blocked it completely short at the net. They got the lift and they got into the rally from the beginning. And I think the only thing that the English player hasn't tested yet is actually playing these very, very short block shots to the net and see whether they can force lifts from a situation like that.
Service over.
Well, the run of points comes to an end at 4.
8-12.
That's a great, great defensive shot from Lauren Smith.
9-12.
Watanabe took a chance and it's not going all the way cross-court as he wanted. I'm sure he wanted to hit to the forehand side of Lauren Smith, but the placement let him down a bit.
Oh my goodness.
Making amends.
He is so fast back in court,
13,
isn't he?
9.
And plays a winning smash once more. Yeah, nice drop shot from Marcus Ellis.
10-13.
Gotta start making their move now, the English combination. Nice drop again. Oh, between the legs.
See, that's what Marcus Ellis did. He made that block shot completely short and then forcing the lift. Of course, a little bit lucky for the English that Higashino not able to control it and play it out of the court. But nevertheless, it was a complete block shot. Mm. Very, very short that did the trick.
Drive serve from Ellis. Very effective.
12-13.
Yeah, I can smash with full pirouette from Yuta Watanabe. He was faster on his spin there than a ballet dancer.
Yeah.
Started off with the net shot on the return of serve.
It did. Seems to be the right formula.
Well left. That's well left by Yuta Watanabe.
And he really left it on purpose. He had the chance to play it.
15-13.
Had the chance to make a swing of that one.
Longest rally of this second game. Pressure
14,
on the return 15. Of serve.
Wonderful rally. Oh, that's good placement.
That is superb.
So like that he did not go down the centre.
16-14.
good serve again. Oh, my goodness. How many net cords have we seen in this match? Fair few. Got badly deflected by the net cord. No chance for Marcus Ellis.
Service over.
Well, I think we're almost at the point of now or never as far as the English pair are concerned. There's another net cord. Drove the shuttle back though, didn't he, Morton?
Yeah, good defensive shot. Of course, lots of luck, but still, good play. This is a crucial serve. Good serve too. It's another good smash from Yuta Watanabe.
The placement is just excellent, isn't it?
Yeah. 18, there wasn't much of a gap. 16. Down her forehand side there because she'd moved her base across.
Yes, she did. Standing very close to the sideline, but still Watanabe managed to find that forehand. But it is interesting to see what it actually means in terms of play. If you are totally on top, as what we saw with the Japanese in the opening game, and now 17-18, and suddenly more mistakes, other kinds of mistakes, creeping into the game of the Japanese here. Very lucky from Watanabe. Had that not one gone over, it would have been 18-0.
Yeah, but yet another 17. Net cord.
Yep.
Extraordinary number in this match. 2-point advantage and 2 points away from a third All England final for Watanabe and Higashino. Oh, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant from Higashino. And it's match point opportunities.
20, match point, 17.
Yeah, well saved.
Service over.
What a rally!
and the famous drop shot, setting up the opportunity.
What a magnificent rally to end the match. And Yuta Watanabe and Orisa Higashino book their place in the All England final for a third time, breaking English hearts in the process by beating Marcus Ellis and Lauren Smith in two straight games. 21-10, 21-18 in a match that, well, it was very one-sided in the opening game, but I really did come alive in the second. Just shy of 40 minutes in duration, and 21-10, 21-18. So a third final in 4 years. That's pretty good going for Watanabe and Higashino. So that confirms that it's an all-Japanese mixed doubles final, along with the all-Japanese women's doubles and all-Japanese men's doubles final tomorrow. Well, English heart's broken because it's been 14 years.